हेलो, गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स। मीटिंग अगेन। जस्ट नाउ देयर वाज अ मैसेज फ्रॉम डॉक्टर पल्लवी दैट टुडे वी माइट हैव थॉट दैट डॉक्टर असरा सर विल शेयर अ वीडियो। इट वाज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज ऑफ सम ऑफ द रीजंस, बट जस्ट शी सेड एंड दैट्स व्हाई आई कंसीडर दैट लेट अस डू दैट, व्हाई नॉट? Now there is a time and why not to share? So I recollected two cases in my mind and a very simple remedy. But the practical application of that remedy is very, very important. And those things I want to share. So we'll start with the first case and then I will teach you the materia medica. So let us listen some of the glimpses of the cases. One of patient came to me, it was in 1995, I think so. Patient came to me with a severe bronchial asthma. And I asked him, what's your name and what is your problem? That's all. He started narrating his case and nothing was asked. And he goes on continuously talking a number of things. Really a sufferer of a chronic bronchial asthma with severe trouble, but he was continuously talking and talking. I never asked a second question thereafter. After 1 hour, I stopped him. I said, it's okay, I understood your case. Let us examine. I will examine you and I will give the medicine. And I was damn sure about the lachesis because the way he has narrated the case, it was very, very nice. And that's why when I prescribed lachesis with a placebo, immediately he felt better. Nearly about 2-3 follow-ups, he was absolutely normal. And one day he called me in the afternoon, around 2 o'clock. He was from Satra, nearly about 30-35 kilometers from Sangamne. He called me and said, Doctor, I had a very severe common cold. Since morning, I have there are 10 handkerchiefs were wet. And I'm so disturbed and continuously sneezing. There is watering from the nose, watering from the eyes, and I'm so disturbed. Is it possible to get your appointment? I will reach you over there. I said, yes, do come. And he said that this was the problem which I used to suffer earlier before asthma. So it was a good thing for me. So he came right from there. He started from Satra to Sangamer in his car. And after half an hour, he was there in front of me. And he was telling that he was absolutely, what has happened, I don't know. But during traveling, nothing, not a single sneeze was there. He was very happy looking. I said, where is the problem? I asked that question. And immediately within a minute or two, he started again getting running up of his nose, again watering, sneezing. And he said, this is what was there in the morning. I was so disturbed because of it. It was just, I was rubbing the nose and everything coming out, tap, tap, tap. It is pure watering from the nose along with lacrimation. So it was very clear cut case of everyone knows. Because here, the few important things, if you are able to understood it, it's very simple. That first important thing is that he was having acute coryza, rhinitis, with watering from nose, watering from eyes. It was burning, like here, burning his nose. But modalities are very important. He was at his home. At that time, there was a problem. When he started in open air in his car, there was nothing, so it was not there. And when he re-entered into my consulting room, again he started getting the problem. So aggravation, coryza, aggravated in a room, ameliorated in open air, aggravated when enters again into the warm room. Typical of a Allium Sepa. And I prescribed Allium Sepa. I put a drop of Allium Sepa on his tongue. It was a reply which comes out after half minute, and the way he said, "Doctor, jadoo zali, magic has happened." Immediately after the action of Allium Sipa, everything stopped. Nothing was there, not a drop of a coryza, not a drop of a cold, not lacrimation, no sneezing, everything stopped with Allium Sipa 30, single dose. And it worked instantaneously. That is very important. It worked instantaneously because the simulimum was very perfect. So on that day, on the basis of this, I have prescribed the Allium Sipa, and it was a very clear-cut prescription. So this is the first case. And thereafter, he talked with me nearly half an hour, and he was completely normal. And he recovered from asthma and from chronic coryza from that day, and he recovered completely. Another case of Allium Sipa, it was there with me. One of my friend who is an anesthetist, and he had done his total hip replacement for his avian problem. And after doing that surgery, he came after 5 to 6 days later on to the Sangam. He had done it either in Pune or Mumbai. I could not recollect, but it was nearly about 7-8 years back. And after that operation, he got a very severe neuralgia in his hip. It was tremendously severe neuralgia. He was continuously, day and night, he was crying with pain. He has given all types of analgesics. Even a carbamazepine was given to him, and he was not getting settled. It was so severe, character was so severe that he was really weeping because of that. That much severity was there. So I considered that it is a neuralgia in his hip, in his thigh, after an operation. So it is nothing but the operation which has been done is nothing but a replacement therapy. It is total hip replacement. So part of the hip is cut down, and there was a prosthesis. So there is one symptom in Allium Sipa. So it is neuralgic pains like long thread, traumatic chronic neuritis, neuralgia of a stump after amputation, burning and stinging pains. This is very typical of Allium Sipa. It was there in my mind. And on that day, on that presentation, it was just like cutting a hip joint and replacing it. So it was just a stump which remains over there. I prescribed him Allium Sipa. I have given him Allium Sipa in 1 mg potency at that time, because it was very susceptibilities was very high, then pain was very severe character. And to my surprise, next day morning he called me and he said, "Sir, everything is stopped. There is no more pain. The pains which were not responding to carbamazepine or any analgesics responded very nicely to the Allium Sipa." See, this we never consider. Generally, what happens, we consider Allium Sipa only for the coryza. But this symptom we used to miss. This is second case which I have understood that this was very good application of Allium Sipa, and patient recovered instantaneously. Next day he was normal. And one more case was there with me. It's again a way back where Allium Sipa worked beautifully in that case. That patient was, patient came to me with a recurrent colic. It was recurrent pain in abdomen. And he used to say, "Doctor, I could not get relief. I have taken a lot of treatment, but whenever pain starts, it never stops. Even after giving, and they gave me painkillers or antispasmodics I used to take, but it never stops. Generally, it takes nearly about 6-7 hours and then it stops. And I get that pain whenever I eat the cucumber." It was very characteristic. colic after cucumber is very typical of the Allium sepa. So it, I recollected it from my knowledge of Materia Medica, and I prescribed him directly that the Allium sepa. I have given him Allium sepa. He was in acute pain at that time, and after giving Allium sepa, immediately his pain in abdomen stopped. And I asked him that whenever you get this type of colic, you take another dose. And he met me after a year, and he said that what medicine you have given me at that time, it is still working with me. It is still working, and it is not, I have not taken single dose, the another dose from that day, and I used to eat cucumber without any problem. See, these are very important cases of the Allium sepa, which I want to share with you. That was the thought just I recollected 5 minutes back, and thereafter I started this video. Let us learn Allium sepa from the Allen's keynote, because Allen's, I used to love the Allen's, because Allen's, if you read and read by heart and keep it in your brain and mind, you can apply that Allium sepa very clearly. So we'll read one sentence by sentence, and everything we and will understand, and that is very essential for the application. One more thing, I used to use Allium sepa whenever people comes to you in the month of August, July, August, generally they comes with this typical coryza, then lacrimation with a mild fever, and that typical of a pollen grain fever, because it was the time, and because of that they suffers in the month of July or August. And that there is one sentence in the Allium sepa in Allen's keynotes: hay fever in every August, and Allium sepa works beautifully. And that's why these are the cases which teaches us how to apply Allium sepa. So let us learn the Allium sepa from the Allen's keynotes. We'll read every sentence, understand it, and go ahead. So Allium sepa, it is prepared from common thing, that is the onion, the it is from the Liliaceae family, and Allium sepa is the remedy which shows its proving even in crude form. So whenever anyone is cutting the onion, everyone suffers from that typical type of coryza, lacrimation, and all those features are there in the proving of Allium sepa. Acute catarrhal inflammation of the mucous membranes with increased secretion, very typical of the Allium sepa. Acute catarrhal inflammation. So this is very, very clear. Inflammation of the mucous membrane inside the nose, inside the eyes, and there is watering from it. Catarrhal dull headache. So it is leading towards the sinusitis. Headache is because of the mucous membrane inside the head. Those gets affected. That's why catarrhal dull headache. Dull headache is always the characteristic of the sinusitis. Then, with catarrhal dull headache with coryza, aggravated in the evening. That is modality of the Allium sepa. Evening aggravation is a typical of the Allium sepa. Ameliorated in open air. Just now I have shared the case that how this I used that in that case, and aggravated on returning to a warm room. This is very essential. Returning to a warm room. So patient goes into the open air, and when he returns back again, it starts. That is very typical of the Allium sepa. So he explains over there, compare Euphrasia and Pulsatilla. Yes, Euphrasia, you know that Euphrasia is the remedy having exactly opposite modalities to the Allium sepa. Euphrasia, it is generally better aggravated in open air and better inside the room. Euphrasia, it is the bland coryza with acrid lacrimation. Here it is acrid coryza with the bland lacrimation. Pulsatilla is also having the similar modality. Pulsatilla is also better in open air. So it is very close to the Allium sepa regarding that. But Allium sepa is a very acute in action. Pulsatilla is subacute in action. That is very important thing. One has to understand the pathology behind the remedy. Allium sepa is very, very acute. It touches, it starts immediately. Pulsatilla is little bit slow comparative to Allium sepa. Because pulsatilla, you have a second stage of inflammation, and that's why in whenever there is a discharge, it is not absolutely watery. It is little bit thick. Sometimes it is greenish, sometimes it is yellowish. It is like a plastic exudate sometimes. So that is the second stage of inflammation which you can use to get in pulsatilla. So there is a difference in the alemsipa and pulsatilla. Headache seizes during menses. That is very typical. The very essential modality, very close to the two remedies, lachesis and ginkgum betalicum. Both remedies having amelioration during period of a menses. Alemsipa, it is only headache which patient feels better during menses. In lachesis and ginkgum met, everything gets ameliorated during menses. So headache seizes during menses, returns when the flow disappears. So that is very close to the lachesis and ginkgum met. Yes, lachesis, the discharges ameliorates, basically the menses ameliorates, that is characteristic. Same is true for the ginkgum metallicum. But it is a general modality for the lachesis and ginkgum metallicum. In alemsipa, it is very specific for the headache. Then eyes. See, whenever you are reading, now he starts giving one by one every organ. So he starts with eyes. After headache, eyes burning, biting, smarting as from a smoke. Burning, biting, smarting. The way the smoke enters into your eyes and the feeling which happens over there, it is the same feeling which develops in the alemsipa eye complaint. Must rub them. There is an irritation of the eyes and patient wants to rub them. He wants to rub the nose. He wants to rub the eyes. Watery and suffused. Watery. Capillaries injected. It becomes red as if there it looks very acute conjunctivitis. Capillaries are injected and there is an excessive lacrimation. So this is one more remedy for the conjunctivitis, but here the coryza is accurate. The eye lacrimation is bland. Now he turns towards the nose. Coryza. Coryza is profuse. So there is much quantity. Watery and acrid nasal discharge. It is given in italics and that has its meaning. Whenever anything is given in italics, it has a very much value over there. So acrid nasal discharge with profuse bland lacrimation. Exactly reverse of the euphoresia. So lacrimation is there, profuse, but it is bland. It never causes irritation, but nose, it causes very much severe irritation. Profuse, full of acrid tears, bland and fluent coryza is euphoresia. So that is a comparison between alemsipa and euphoresia. It is given over there by Allen. Then acrid watery discharge dropping from the tip of the nose. So this is one more thing which he explains over there. That tip of the nose, the watering, it is just dropping from the tip of the nose. And that is the acrid, that is causing irritation, that is causing burning of the nose. Like arsenic, like ars iodide, where you can get similar types of features. But in cases of arsenic or ars iodide, it is chronic allergic rhinitis. It is very acute in alemsipa. Whereas in arsenic, it is chronic, sorosypilitic remedy, ars iodide, tubercular remedy. So if the things are recurrent, chronic, then you think about those remedies. Spring coryza, that is very important thing which he has mentioned over there. Generally what happens, there are these seasons which are mentioned over there, that is, we don't never understand exactly which months it is there. So my suggestion is that you just write it down when exactly the spring is there. In India we have only three seasons, but in European countries there are four types of season, and one must know, that's why, exactly which months. Months are very essential for that. So instead of taking it in the similar manner like in India, you might miss a remedy. And that's why the classification of seasons is one must know. So first important thing first important season, that is the autumn, is there. Autumn, it is September, October, November. See, the autumn is there, September, October, November. Second important is winter. Winter is there December, January, February. We have 4 months, but European countries, there are 3 months. So it is December, January, February, it is winter, and then spring starts. Spring is March, April, May. And after March, April, May, the summer starts over there. That is June, July, August. So these are European, this is European classification of the seasons, which we have to apply according to the months over there while considering the modalities. And that's why spring Koraida after damp northeasterly winds. Northeasterly winds. Very important thing which we have learned in geography. Geography, we learned that there are different types of winds are there. In Marathi, we used to say Ishanyavare, northeasterly. That is Ishanyavare. That is very important, northeasterly. And if you are able to understand all those things, if you go out in the nature and if you understand those things, or if you read the weather and understand it, then you can find it out there. So that is very essential. The spring Koraida after damp northeasterly winds, discharge burns and corrodes the nose and the upper limb. Discharge corrodes the nose and upper limb. Very close to the another remedy, Arum triphyllum. But in Arum triphyllum, there is very severe burning and it becomes so corroded and patient wants to rub his nose over there on the below the pillow or on the pillow, and he wants to put his head below the pillow along with a very severe cough over there in Arum triphyllum. So that is another thing one must know. Then hay fever in August every year. That's what I have said, that this is again a very common remedy I have used. I have prescribed it number of times with success. With typical Koraida associated with fever, it is the general practitioners used to say it is viral fever, viral attack. Allium sepa is very important in those months. Violent sneezing on rising from the bed, from handling the peaches. That is very important. From handling the peaches, immediately the sneezing starts. Or whenever patient wakes up in the morning and sneezing starts. That is very, very classical of the Allium sepa. Then he turns one more pathology which is there. That is nasal polypus. There are multiple remedies. Allium sepa is one remedy, then Cucurbitum marum is another remedy, then the sanguinaria is another remedy, the sanguinaria nitricum is another remedy, the sorinum is there. In fact, I have shared on my blog a case of nasal polypus treated with the, I think it was treated with sanguinaria, and very classical case, it has completely recovered. Allium sepa also has a nasal polypus. A nasal polypus along with lot of watering from the nodes, watering from the nodes with typical modalities of Allium sepa, then you can think about the Allium sepa. Then he turns towards the larynx, catarrhal laryngitis. So in Allium sepa, whenever Koraida is there, there is little bit hoarseness of a voice, catarrhal laryngitis. Cough compels patient to grasp the larynx. That is very important. There is patient is coughing and he keeps his hands over here. That is very difficult because he feels as if it will torn. That is very important. Seems as if cough would tear it. That is very essential. So patient is having typical modalities of Allium sepa along with a dry cough and cough with hoarseness of voice with severe pain over there in larynx, and patient keeps his hand over here. That is Allium sepa. That is another thing which you can watch, which you can perceive from the patient. You don't have to ask a lot of questions. The way patient sits in front of you while coughing, that gives you an idea of prescribing the remedy. So that is very essential to understand. Then one more thing, the colic. Just now I have shared a case. Colic from the cold by getting feet wet. Colic from cold by getting feet wet means what? Whenever patient keeps feet in a water, because immediately a colic starts, that is one important modality. Colic from overeating, colic from cucumbers, that is very important. Salad generally contains the cucumber, and that there is a pain in the abdomen. colic hemorrhoidal. See, this is very important. Colic and colon is written over there. So for every word thereafter, so colic from cold by taking getting feet wet, then colic is applicable for after overeating, colic from cucumbers. So this word is applicable because this was the method of writing that time, and that is very clear cut. So within a sentence you can write it down n number of things. So colic hemorrhoidal, there is so a remedy associated with hemorrhoids also. Colic of a children, colic of a aggravated after sitting, colic ameliorated after moving about. Modalities are very important. Aggravated by sitting in one place, patient feels better by moving about. That type of colic is there. It is alemsis. So this is very important thing one has to understand. Then neuralgic pains like a long thread in face, head, neck, chest, and these types of pains, patient comes, doctor, there are neuralgic pains here and here and here and there. They talk, it remains for a second and it disappears. Such types of pains are there. In Marathi, we used to call it samkanikta. So that is very typical of alemsipa. Traumatic chronic neuritis. This is a very important thing. The case which I have shared of a person who has worked out for the total hip replacement, that is traumatic neuritis, neuralgia of a stump after amputation. So whenever anyone cuts his leg because of some reason, and if there is neuralgia which persists in that specific part, alemsipa is a very important remedy. The burning and stinging pains. Next word is very important. Panarrhytia along with colon, which is mentioned over there. What is panarrhytia? Panarrhytia is nothing but the inflammation and infection of the part of the digits around the nail. Nail bed infection or around the nail, there is a typical infection and inflammation. And there is severe pain number of times with the patient. Think about the alemsipa. We generally forget alemsipa, but alemsipa is a very important remedy for that purpose. So panarrhytia with red streaks up the arms. So there are pains, and along with the hand, it enters into the arms, red streaks which appears over there. Pains drive to despair. The pains are so severe, the patient becomes depressed, despair because of it. Panarrhytia in childbed. Childbed is a very important thing. This word, generally no one understands, no one reads exactly what it means. Exactly, childbed is the period. Childbed period is during and immediately following the parturition period is called a childbed period. So panarrhytia which develops during that period is the alemsipa. See, alemsipa is having a multiple applications and most practical, most clinical. But generally, we used to consider alemsipa in our mind with fixed idea. It is a remedy for chorea. No, it's a remedy for number of things. One should not forget all those things. All are very essential. All are very important in practice. Then, sore and raw spots on feet, especially heel from friction. What is it? There are sore spots on feet, there are sore spots on heel because of friction, and those are painful again and again. Epicaceous when feet are rubbed sore, dioscoroids. Dioscoroids says that whenever it is very epicaceous when the feet are rubbed sore, after rubbing there is soreness and it used to pain, it becomes sore. Think of the alemsipa. We generally never think about the alemsipa in such conditions. We can consider only for few things. Then he says one more thing, the plebitis, inflammation of the veins, puerperal, that is the puerperal period after forceps delivery. See, again, very clear cut indication, clinical indication. This is one more thing which I have used with one patient. It was not recovering after the forceps delivery. Patient was disturbed so much because of it, and it was not going, disappearing, and after alemsipa patient was recovered completely. So this is one more clinical indication, phlebitis puerperal after the forceps delivery. So this is what Alemsipa is there. So Alemsipa is not a very small remedy. Alemsipa is having action on different systems, and at all levels it has a clinical application over there, which you can perceive over there. The relationships which you have to understand, see what he says. Complementary to the phosphorus, pulsatilla and thuja. The complementary remedies are there. Phosphorus is there, the pulsatilla is there, thuja is there. So they generally, after the Alemsipa, you can think about those remedies. Compatible before calcarea and silica in polypus. In polypus cases, compatible Alemsipa followed by calcarea, Alemsipa followed by silica. Yes, it is very important remedy for nasal polypus. Similar to Ipraxia, but the coryza and lacrimation are opposite. Already we have learned about that. Bad effects from getting wet, and he has compared it with Rushtox. Yes, this is again one more common modality of the Alemsipa one has to consider. So this is one must think over there. And last, the common modalities or aggravations, predominantly in the evening and in the warm room. Aggravation, that is very difficult, like pulsatilla. Aggravation in open air is Euphrasia. Here it differs from Euphrasia. That is the opposite modality to the Alemsipa as well as pulsatilla. And amelioration in cold room and open air, that is very close to the pulsatilla. See, this is what one has to think about the Alemsipa. And everything is there in Alensky notes. If we read it by heart, we understand the remedy. Read it again and again. You will read the remedy from the Alens one times, two times, three times, 100 times. You will get every time a prescribing condition regarding it. You will get more clinical verification and clinical confidence of prescribing the remedy. And that's why Alensky notes, one should not forget. One should not overlook. Instead of reading lot of things, concentrate more. For the newcomers, I will suggest that they should go for the Alensky notes again and again, and you'll get ample to prescribe in Alensky notes. And that's why I just love the Alensky notes. So it was nice time to meet you again. I think Dr. Jayesh Sagar sir was there. Thank you, sir, attending the session. It was without intimation. I have started immediately, just Pallavi said, but she is not there. Dr. Rakhi Mathur, madam, yes, thank you being there. Vaibhav, Chandrakant, Vinod, then Manoranjan Rathi, yes, thank you, all of you being there. And will again, whenever time permits, I will share a few more cases in future. So it's a nice time to being with you. I will share clinical experiences with Alensky notes, with Mitra Medica or some more organon whenever the time permits. Thank you attending session. We'll meet again whenever I have a time, and we'll have a good meet. Thanks a lot.